And now we're going to describe the canopy gap intercept method. Gap intercept measurements provide information about the proportion of the line covered by large gaps between plants. Large gaps between plant canopies are important indicators of potential wind erosion and weed invasion. For this method, we always start at the zero end of the line, reading from left to right, so that the numbers on the line are always upright and visible. There are a couple of simple tools that we can use in this method to help us do measurements. One is the line point pin. This helps you look straight down on the graduated edge of the tape, preventing parallax. And this will move along the tape from left to right fashion. Another simple tool that we can use is something that will span the length of your minimum gap size. In this case, I have a yucca stalk. You can have a stick, another metal rod, or anything that will work that's cut to the minimum gap size. The reason this is helpful is when you're moving along the tape, you can quickly put this between plants and determine if the gaps between those plants meets the minimum gap size without looking at the numbers on the tape. Here we have two shrubs. There's a space between them. We need to judge if that space is large enough. So I'm going to put down my measuring stick and nope, it's not large enough, so we just gloss over it. This is considered continuous canopy between this shrub and that shrub. Depending on your objectives, annual plants may or may not be measured on this method. Just make sure you record that on the data sheet when you measure annual plants. An important aspect of this method is that we don't consider live and dead canopy as different. They both cover the ground surface and they both protect the ground from raindrop impact. So when measuring gaps, don't consider whether a plant is live or dead. Also, litter on the ground is not counted as canopy, so bypass that in your mind when you're reading along the tape. For this method, no species ID is needed, so that if somebody on your team is not familiar with the plants at a site, they can make the measurements. The way we do this method is to start at the zero end of the line and read from left to right. And we always want to read along the graduated side of the tape, and this is an area-less measurement we want to make along the edge of that tape. Using your pin, we want to look straight down, prevent parallax. Always look down from the top of the pin all the way down to the ground and straight down perpendicular to the edge of the tape to the ground, moving left to right. I'm waiting for, as I move, the canopy to touch the pin. And then once the canopy touches the pin, I put down my fingers, which are 3 centimeters apart, and asking myself, is 50% of that 3 centimeter area covered with vegetation? So I'm looking down from the top, seeing if 50% is covered. If it is, then the point at which this pin stopped on the tape is the end of that first gap. In this case, the gap went from 0 to 34. To stop this gap, we're moving down the line. My pin touches this small grass. However, there's not enough coverage in a 3 centimeter area for that to count as a gap stopper. So we move through that grass, and I'm moving up to the snakeweed here. I encounter that first leaf, and again, looking 3 centimeters into the plant, there's not enough coverage there to stop a gap yet. So I'm continuing my readings into the plant until I encounter a leaf that has 3 centimeters of coverage down the line. And in this case, that occurs right here at 123. That was how we recorded the end of a gap. To record the beginning of a gap, move through the canopy, position the pin at the edge of the canopy, and then look back 3 centimeters again. Ask yourself, is 50% of that 3 centimeter segment covered with canopy? In this case, yes, it is. So the start of this gap is 55. Another point I need to make is there has to be at least 20 centimeters of space succeeding from 55 in order for that to be a gap. In this case, there is. I lay down my stick. There's at least 20, and we can move on down the line. Grasses sometimes present the most difficult situation in the canopy gap method. When you're reading the edges of grasses, they can be quite diffuse, and so you have to keep in mind your 3-centimeter rule on each edge and to judge as quickly and as accurately as you can 50% coverage of that 3-centimeter area. So between these two grasses, the 3-on here and the black grama here, we have very diffuse canopies. So what I'm trying to do is to find the edge of that canopy with my 3 centimeters. I'm going to say it's around 124 here, and then moving down the line, I'm coming into contact with a few blades of black grama here, but it's not diffuse enough yet. I'm going to move over here, and it's not until the 50 that I'm going to end that gap. So this gap went between the 23 and the 50. When reading the lines, it's important to stay on top of the line on the graduated side, using your pin as a guide, so the parallax is not a problem. And when you approach shrubs, take the reading end of gap here, and then you have to get up inside these shrubs sometimes. It's uncomfortable, but you have to stay on top of the line to get an accurate reading. Which brings up another point. Sometimes inside shrubs, there can be gaps. In this case, we have a single mesquite individual shrub here, but there is a gap. The gap preceding this mesquite shrub stops here with a combination of both grass and mesquite shrub. That's an important point to make because we're not concerned about individual species or individuals in this method. It's only about functional cover units on the ground. And then within this shrub, we have a gap. The gap starts here and ends here. Another point to make is even though you have an individual plant on the ground, there can be gaps within it. And then moving on past the end of this gap, we have the start of another gap outside the shrub here. Live and dead plant canopies can stop gaps. In this case, we have a dead spirobolus plant, and if we came up on this side, we're reading the line, that gap would stop right here, and then the gap start would be way on the other side of this black grama, because this dead plant canopy in combination with this live plant canopy functionally covers this unit of ground. And so we have the gap start here. This is an example of gap edges that might be a little bit confusing. On this side we have Tobosa grass. If you use your 3-centimeter rule and go backwards, you'll see that the gap start is around here, and then moving forwards on the line bypasses these few blades. Coming up to around here, again we have our 3-centimeter ruler on your fingers. So around here is going to be the end of this gap. What I'm going to do now is run through the canopy gap method at full speed. Michelle's going to record for me. She's back behind me so she doesn't step on the line. I have my pointing device and my spacing device, in this case 20 centimeters. Keeping in mind my form the whole time I'm doing this, get my eyes right over the graduated side of the tape, the entire line, keeping low to the ground as possible, and keeping in mind the parallax problem with the pin. Okay. Another thing you might notice is it's a little breezy today, and that creates an additional problem that sometimes you will encounter. If you go up and touch the edge of vegetation, and if it's breezy, sometimes that vegetation will knock back and forth on the pin. What you need to do in that case is just take an instant reading and just move on. Don't deliberate, because the longer you sit there, the more you're going to become confused on whether or not to move along the line. The easy solution to that is just go up to the plant once it touches, make an instant reading, and move on. Okay, Michelle, are you ready?
Ready.
Start 0, end 36, gap start 56, end 124. Start
303, end 400, start 561, end 595, start 820, end 845, start 972, end 996, start 1125, end 1190, start 1228, end 1268, start 1311, end 1335, start 1447, end 1472, start 1628, end 1662, start 1761, end 1936, start 1955, end 1978, start 2198, end 2244, start 2270, end 2326, start 2336, end 2420, start 2552, end 2574, start 3104, end 3146, start 3288, end 3356, start 3380, end 3411, start 3472.